Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asia Newsline, and here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 18th of July. Security forces neutralized two terrorists as they prevented a liberation attempt in Jammu and Kashmir's Kupwara. Bangladesh student protesters call for complete shutdown nationwide, at least 10 dead and 400 injured. And watchdog finds US cross-check failures may have helped terrorists in Afghanistan. And now for all the details. Security forces successfully thwarted an infiltration attempt along the line of control in the Kiran sector of Kupwara in Jammu and Kashmir by eliminating two terrorists. The anti-infiltration operations are still continuing. Earlier, two Indian Army soldiers were injured in an encounter with terrorists in the Kastigarh area of Doda district in Jammu and Kashmir. Initial treatment was administered at the government hospital in Doda, and now they are being airlifted to the army hospital through an army chopper. The encounter comes days after four army soldiers, including an officer, were killed while battling terrorists in the Doda encounter.
वे शाम को 8-9 बजे के करीब आर्मी आई थी तो उसके बाद हम भी गए उधर आर्मी वालों के साथ बातचीत की तो जब वो उधर से गए तो फिर बोलने लगे हमें जाओ सो जाओ अब तो हम आके सो गए तो उसके बाद 2 बजे फायरिंग शुरू हो गई तो हम अंदर सोए हुए थे हमें कोई पता नहीं था उस वक्त बाहर निकलने भी नहीं देते थे और निकलना भी नहीं चाहिए तो सुबह वैसे ही 5 बजे जब रोशनी वोशनी हुई तो हम निकले बाहर तो उस वक्त फायरिंग शायरिंग बंद हो गई थी सारी तो जब बाहर निकले हम तो देखा दो आर्मी जवान जख्मी थे एक खुद चल के गया तो दूसरे को स्ट्रेचर पे उठा के रोड तक ले आ गया
Moving on, Russia on Thursday said that India has been subjected to enormous pressure by international powers due to its energy ties with Moscow and called it completely unjustified. Russian Foreign Minister Sergey Lavrov, while addressing concerns about Prime Minister Narendra Modi's recent trip to Moscow, said that India is a great power that sets its own national interests, determines its own national interests and chooses its own partners. Lavrov also termed Ukraine's remarks on the recent meeting between President Vladimir Putin and Prime Minister Narendra Modi in Moscow as insulting. India has not yet condemned Russia's invasion of Ukraine in 2022 and has consistently pitched for a resolution of the conflict through dialogue and diplomacy. India had said its priority is to safeguard the interest of its citizens, ensuring they do not bear the brunt of actions by other countries or regions when it comes to essential commodities like fertilizer and food. Pakistan on Wednesday urged probe from Afghanistan following a deadly terrorist attack on army camps, which resulted in the killing of 8 soldiers and injured many others. Pakistan Foreign Office said that the deputy head of mission of the Embassy of Afghanistan in Islamabad was summoned to deliver Pakistan's strong demark over the deadly terrorist attack. The foreign minister said that the terrorist attack was carried out by Hafiz Gul Bahadur Group based in Afghanistan along with Tehreek-e-Taliban Pakistan and also is responsible for the deaths of hundreds of civilians and law enforcement officials in multiple terrorist attacks inside Pakistan. Islamabad has urged Kabul to fully investigate and take immediate, robust and effective action against the perpetrators of the attack and to prevent the recurrence of such attacks against Pakistan using the territory of Afghanistan. And after the death of 10 people during the violent anti-quota protest in Bangladesh, Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina, during an address to the nation on Wednesday, vowed to take strict actions against those who are responsible for the incident. At least 10 people were killed and more than 400 were injured in the clashes, which was the most violent day so far in weeks of protests regarding public sector job quotas for the children of freedom fighters who fought in the 1970 War of Independence. Student protesters, agitated by high youth unemployment, have called for the complete shutdown nationwide. Authorities had closed all public and private universities indefinitely from Wednesday and sent riot police and the Border Guard paramilitary force to university campuses to ensure law and order. The demonstrations intensified after Hasina refused to meet the protesters' demands. The United States, rights groups, as well as the United Nations have called on Bangladesh to uphold the right to peaceful protest amid the violent clashes.
কিভাবে সরকার এটা বলতে পারে যে রাজনৈতিকীকরণ করা হচ্ছে যেখানে প্রথম থেকেই আমরা বলছি যে আমরা সাধারণ শিক্ষার্থী আমরা চাচ্ছি যে একটা দেশে কিভাবে এটা তো একটা ন্যূনতম কমন সেন্সের ব্যাপার যে একটা দেশের 100% এর মধ্যে 56% কখনো কোটা থাকতে পারে না কখনো থাকতে পারে না কোন সুস্থ একটা দেশে সুস্থ সমাজ ব্যবস্থায় কখনো 56% কোটা এটা মেনে নেওয়ার মতো না
মুভিং অন An U.S. watchdog on Wednesday said that the two State Department bureaus could not prove compliance with internal policies for vetting aid groups in Taliban-ruled Afghanistan that received $293 million in funds, raising a risk that extremists may have profited. The report stated that it is critical that the state knows who is actually benefiting from this assistance in order to prevent the aid from being diverted to the Taliban or other sanctioned parties. The report further added that the Taliban has tried to obtain US aid funds through several means, including the establishment of humanitarian organizations. It said there is an increased risk that terrorists and terrorist-affiliated individuals and entities may have illegally benefited. The U.S. remains the largest aid donor to impoverished Afghanistan nearly 3 years after the Taliban seized Kabul as the last U.S. troops completed a chaotic pullout following 20 years of war with the Islamist militant and has provided more than $17.9 billion in assistance to Afghanistan. Amid strained ties, India on Wednesday reaffirmed its commitment to major infrastructure in the Maldives after Maldives Minister of Transport and Civil Aviation Mohammad Amin and Indian High Commissioner Munu Mahavar made an official visit to Hanimadu International Airport development site earlier this week. Mahavar said that the project is a major infrastructure project that is being implemented with Indian support and Indian assistance in Maldives. He said this project will have a transformative impact for the entire northern region of Maldives as it will improve connectivity and boost tourism. India has been involved in 47 high-impact community development projects in the Maldives. And the Indian Navy has rescued at least 9 of the 16 member crew who went missing after an oil tanker capsized off Oman's major industrial port of Duqm while one was found dead. Those rescued so far include 8 Indians and 1 Sri Lankan, said a spokesperson for the Indian Navy, which is helping with search and rescue operations. The operations are being conducted in challenging weather conditions as the area is experiencing rough seas and strong winds. Duqm Port, located on Oman's southeast coast, lies close to its major oil and gas mining projects. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.